Okay, good evening. Tonight I'm gonna talk politics. Yes, as on the eve of this election, tomorrow is an election again here in the United States. Not a primary election for a president, but the one, you know, for other things. The drama that's going on here in the United States with this election cycle, the way it works, is it's unfair because it is not a vote that is one-to-one. You know, your vote is counted, you vote, d'entrée, and it goes off and it gets counted. So at the end, you know, they all get tallied up and they say, well, it's all the Republicans, or, oh, it's all the Democrats. It doesn't work that way. It just has to be a little bit in the majority on one side towards one particular delegate of the House or the state representatives, the senators, and just one little bit this way or that way to sway the vote. And all you can have hundreds and hundreds of thousands and just tossed out, so they're not counted, because they just go on this majority moment. And so if you're in the majority moment, but you are the underling side, all of those underling votes don't get counted. So you could have 40,000, let's say, versus 50,000. Okay, the 40,000 aren't counted after a certain time frame. Okay, they're just counted in that first moment for that particular delegate. Okay, so then you'll have that 40,000 just lost, when in reality that 40,000 needs to be counted with all of the others, whether they're 80,000 or 90,000 or 120,000. They all have to be bundled together, and then that 50,000 and all those other ones have to get bundled together, and that's a fair system. Okay, the United States is not a fair system, because we're not a fair political system. It's actually acting erroneously, illegally, all kinds of things. We can say all kinds of things, but when we're in another country of the world, we're like, what's going on there? All of their citizens are like waving and yelling, and they're saying, this is not a democracy. We're not being counted. We are not heard. Okay, and then we have all the, like, these climate summits or whatever they go to, and then somebody says, yeah, we'll go with, and then, you know, a couple months later it's all retracted and just pushed under the carpet, and oh no, that really wasn't going to happen, you know. So all of these things that we have been, you know, trying to push for keep getting stomped on. And this is a lot to do with this fairness of vote, okay, because we don't have the fairness of voting. So that is the one thing that we must change. Now, another thing, because we have all of this climate change that it has to happen, you know, we're talking about, what was it, somebody I was reading in Rolling Stone magazine, that by the year 2050, it could very well be the entire population of the United States, around the world, you know, and coastal areas, all drowned. So quite a lot of people that, I don't know if they were going to drown or just have to live for higher water or a higher area, you know, but yeah, that's a lot of people misplaced. Okay, so a terrible thing is happening, and we have to make these real drastic moves for climate change to stop changing. So we just kind of live it out here. We're at the 420 ppms or whatever. Just, you know, we're gonna probably get to that next year and a half. Pretty simple. Next year, maybe next year after that. But yeah, pretty simple. It'll be like all the time, and we've got to reverse that, or halt it. You know, we can't just keep going up and up and up. You know, it doesn't work that way. We won't survive. You know, physically, it'll kill us. So, forget all of this global, what do we call it, the meltdowns or whatever, the sea level rising. It's not just going to be about that, it's going to be about these CO2 ppms and us being able to absorb it, each one, you know, on a daily scale. Because that'll be the outside, that's the outside ppm, and when you bring it on the inside of your house, that'll rise up whatever your inside was going to be. So let's say you're living at 1200 in your house, you're going to go even higher. And so all of these things are drastic to your health. And so this unhealthy living, again. Anyway, so all I didn't mean to get off on the climate change at all and talk about it. We're really needing to fine. We need the EU to start fining the United States. We need Canada to start fining the United States. We need all of these, Iceland, we need everybody to start just saying, hey, you guys are not complying. You're one of the biggest polluters in the whole world. You're not complying. So thusly, there goes a fine. And in that reaction state, we start something that is pretty much, it's been done a lot between Britain and the EU, a lot of fines going on, and it's civil, it's very civil, it's very civilized, but it really does have to, we have to start putting our foot right in that US door and saying, you can't do that. You can't do that to the rest of the world. You know, when the rest of the world is starting to like change and modify and adapt their industries, and the United States is still a curmudgeon, is still not changing, well, who is gonna just, they can just do what they want, you know. No, I mean, at some point we have to say no. They are the culprit. The United States is the culprit. They are selling the worst cars ever, the worst trucks ever all across this United States. Number one sales, and that's what they're pushing, and that's what they are not giving. They're not giving any breaks to these electric car purchases. Nothing. It's just a big scandal. A big scandal of the same. And with the scandal of the same, they need to be reprimanded and fined. Okay, now there are different ways you can pull some kind of like an export taxation. Like, you're gonna bring things into my France, you're gonna bring some things into my Hungary, you are gonna have an extra tax to pay because you guys are not up to snuff. Your voting is absolutely unlawful to the actual citizens. You have to remember, when they created that Constitution of the United States of America, it was actually at a time when they were had slavery. It was at a time, you know, take it back, guys. You know, we need to change it. We need to, this whole United States political really needs a new right, a new constitution. Okay, so you can tax them as they're exporting to another. Let's say you're exporting off into France. There you go. You're going to get an extra tax. So you tax those businesses. That's one way to punish. You have to start punishing. We'll call them climate criminals. The countries of the United of the world that are climate criminals. Okay, so it's where I'm trying to head tonight is we have to really start not just finger pointing. We really have to find them, and those monies can head off to the EU. They can head off to the countries that did form the organization of the climate criminals against. That's it. We've had it. We are not any longer gonna let them slide by, let them slip through the cracks, like they have been doing. Okay, so you have to play tough. You have to play like the EU. And that's what the EU has been doing to Britain. And that's why Britain's all been running away. Oh, I don't want to be in it, or whatever. Because of the fines. They've been giving them fine after fine after fine because they do things late. Or do things, oh, the British way. We only want our pound sterling and all of that. All of these fines have been going on. But it isn't effective. It wakes them up. It's effective. And in this instance, this is we've got hundreds of millions. I don't know how many millions in the US, maybe 80 million of us. I don't know. I'm not good on the numbers. 80, maybe 100 million, maybe 120. But we have all of these millions of people, but they're not getting a fair vote. So already they're slighted. So that system should be fined. I don't want to deal with that system. I don't want to deal with the United States because they're like backward. You know, they're a backward constitution that they have, that they're spilling out, that people are supposed to use. It's just backward. It doesn't acknowledge the person for the person when they walk into that voting booth. They're not given the same value as another. So it's a bad system. Okay, so other ways we can find them. The climate change, they don't pull it up to snuff for the climate change. You have the exportation taxations. You have regular outright fines. That's it. Just a fine, like $1 million a day or whatever, until you guys adhere. Like, what is this that he tried to get out, or he did get out of the Paris summit or whatever? That's it. Fine every day, you know, $1 million. Dung 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 dung. Change that system. Change your constitution. The others can definitely fine for that also. They don't want to deal. They don't have to deal with such a bad group, of politics, an unfair group of politics. I mean, and it's set up in such a way that the United States citizens can't even really have a coup. It is that bad. They can't have a coup because they have such a military militia. The president has such a military militia all his own. So it's impossible for the citizens to have a coup and take over and say, no, we're changing the system. So in a way, this is a beg. We are begging now. I'm begging now. I'm going to beg these others. I'm going to beg these others to just, hey, don't deal with the United States. Unless we get a fine money, we want the pay money from them because they're treating their citizens in an objectionable manner. They're unfair. They're unfair to their citizens. That alone should be enough. Okay. So, but then we have the climate derogatories. You know, when they say, yeah, we're going to do this on the climate, and then they don't. Those types of things. And when you see, like, the spikes and go, oh, this is the United States, and over here is Malaysia, you know, or something like that, it's like, what the heck? I mean, the United States is a big hog, is a big climate killer, killing the climate around us. You know, they need to be fined, you know, the United States. So that's it. So we need to form a coalition with those who are working, in those countries that are working for climate change, and also those countries that deal with the United States on an export basis to start putting new taxes in because they have an unfair constitution, they have an unfair voting system. That does not allow the citizens the right to change it. So therefore, this big ugly industry spike that you see will never go away until we really start getting some reprimands from others. Okay, anyway, that's my take on it.